Yeah, that's great. I some of that was a response to COVID-19, much of it. And do you think it's a different level of innovation than we've seen in the past?
So, maybe I can go first. So COVID was a big shock that forced companies to look hard at their on-site benefit offering, especially on-site ones, and reconsider what they meant for in a sort of a virtual and remote work workflow. And things like on-site gym or laundry or cafeteria, food, childcare, all of those things were not really relevant in the remote work environment. I mean, I will put the like whether that remote work situation will, you know, go forever or whether people will come back, I'll put that note aside. But, you know, those changes anyway made companies to rethink about what they have to do that are different from what they used to offer. So before pandemic, you know, some companies, one thing that I found interesting from the discussion is some companies regarded higher compensation as a substitute for a remote work option. And now they question whether they remain substitute or not. So that's one another big theme that came out from the COVID in response to COVID. And companies are searching for ways to identify what work should be done in person, what work can be done remotely, and how can they think about them differently. Another big theme was about whether they need to adjust compensation to match geographic differentials. For example, should the location pay as an explicit line item or not? Right? I see that, you know, amongst those working group participants, some said, yes, we do. Others said, no, we don't do. So there are different approaches companies are taking, but that is certainly a big question that they have to think about in response to this COVID-19 situation. One more thing before I give Diane the microphone is that this COVID forced companies to to think about those like inflation and tight labor market situation. So, you know, employees have some perceptions about like, you know, inflation rate is 7% and my merit increase is 3%, you know, why are you doing it? And a company says to find a way to explain or justify, you know, why they are offering it that way, right? And tight labor market situation, you see like news articles saying that like Walmart increased their minimum wage a lot. Should we do the same? Why aren't you not doing the same, you know, when all of these others are doing? And companies have to do much more research about how prevalent that phenomenon is and whether that's really applicable and relevant to their own company situations. And how can they, you know, tell employees about the approaches they are taking that might be similar or different from other companies are doing, shown in the news articles. So those are some of those changes that I heard and you learned from those discussions in the COVID-19 working group.
And let me respond also, because Beth, I think you asked the question, how much of this is really COVID related? And I think there's an interesting punctuation point here. How much of this is COVID related? Because what we learned from COVID is HR was on the front lines, right? The HR function had to mobilize and mobilize quickly and figure a lot of things out that they never had to deal with before. And CAHRS companies, right, we're proud to say, rose to the occasion. And really, and people were exhausted, but they put forward enormous effort. And we really saw the best of the HR function in dealing with challenges that we have never seen before. So the function has a lot to be proud of for how responsive and capable we were. And we see that. What's interesting is that we're also seeing the roles expand then. The roles become much bigger. And that we heard that loud and clear from our total rewards colleagues that their jobs, they got bigger and they required much more coordination across what had basically been functional silos within the broader HR function. And so, you know, this idea of total rewards as part of employee experience. You know, we heard one participant in a working group, their job title changed and their experience became part of their job. And so there's an interesting moment where we're seeing the HR work is expanding and it's becoming more interdependent and there's a much higher need for coordinating. But you also hear there's also much more need to extend out and talk to your clients, your employees, your customer base, talk to vendors, benchmark against other the other companies, what are others doing? So this broadening, it's getting bigger internally. It's requiring more active engagement externally. I think we have to acknowledge that the jobs are getting harder. The jobs are getting harder. They're bigger, more complex jobs. And because we were able to pivot, there's an expectation that, of course, you can figure this out. And so whether it's an inflationary environment, whether it's global geopolitical instability, whether it's whatever, right? Okay, figure it out. And that, I think it's exciting. I think there's an opportunity for a lot of creativity. I also think we also detected some real exhaustion here.